Okay, we would like to play first. This opener is not very good. I mean, it doesn't have removal or discard, so it's not particularly good in either type of deck, fair or unfair. Though it does have a turn one play, and Wasteland does get better with Deathrite because you can, like, add to your board and Wasteland the second turn. I guess we will not mulligan, though it is kind of borderline. This is also like, scavenging is not one of our more powerful cards. We would play more than one of it, so. Well, go ahead and get a Bayou, I think. We actually almost want them to wasteland us here. Like, we have lots of lands. We have a Deathrite already and another one, so. Not too scared of that. Right, has the Lightning Bolt. I guess we want to waste Deathrite because play around days this way. Yeah, and we will. Alright, so. Unless he's playing some weird deck, playing against Rogue Delver, which is actually probably your best matchup. Not that you totally quit thing, but of the normal decks that you'll face in Legacy, this is one of the better ones to play against. I mean, they have a lot of situational spells that don't do a lot against you. You're kind of okay if will you. Like, you're trying to two for one them all the time. Just that's how your deck operates. They have 18 lands when you're running 24, and they have no basics, so Wasteland is very powerful against them. And you have lots of ways to kill Delver. And even, like, if they have Nimble Mongoose, you have Liliana to deal with that, or just Tarmogoyfs that are bigger, so. Yeah, not the worst matchup, that's for sure. Okay, so I guess we'll do the same thing we did last turn. Play around Daze and then get to Wasteland if he doesn't have the Daze. Ooh, Stifle. Did not think about Stifle there. I don't think that really affects my play. It's still almost certainly correct, because he has to have the Stifle, and also I'm not losing much by trying that. I could wait till he tries to cast something, though. I just actually wasn't thinking about Stifle. Is one of those, like that's. I don't even know if that's, like, particularly good or anything, but that's about as good as it can be. Okay. Then get pretty punished by. Like, I was thinking, like, oh, I can't save the guy from Bolt, but I can save it from Forked Bolt. But anyway. Yeah, like, Stifle's one of those situational cards that often just doesn't do a whole lot against you. And we can somewhat keep this guy in check here with this Deathrite Shaman. I guess we can go ahead and fetch here to not get stifled. It doesn't really matter too much, but. But yeah, I mean, how I played there, like trying to play around days, probably worked out as poorly as it possibly could have, so. Oops. Alright, so. Only has one sorcery, right? No, two sorceries, two instants. Alright, well. I can get rid of sorceries at any rate, so. Go ahead and start that process, shrink his Goyf down one. Bloodbraid's a pretty good card here. Hopefully, like an abrupt decay or something. I guess he could still have days. Can we turn on this? And maybe I should. Guess we want another red block. In case we draw Punishing Fire. Suppose we'll wait a turn. We don't have a lot of resources right now. We have a lightning bolt that doesn't do anything, so probably rather not lose my guy or whatever spell I cast off this, whichever he wants it is. Ahead and get rid of this Cataxium probe. Only take three. Not a bad deal. Guess we could even shrink it one more this next turn. So what we can do is, oh, we have two guys. I thought we only had one guy. Never mind. We cannot do that. Well, in that case, I guess we're gonna spin the wheel. Looking for like a Lily or, yeah, that's fine. More looking for like an Abrupt Decay there, but. Yeah, we'll pay for that. Why not? Could have 2 days, I suppose. But we do like this makes it. We want to keep his yard manageable because of the Nimble Mongoose. So. It's possible we could have like libraried there to try and find Abrupt Decays or Goyfs. Because we need one of those at some point here. Course, I get through saying how good this matchup is, and I'm almost certainly losing this game. This kind of comes down to Tarmogoyf on either side, just more likely mine sticks. I have more ways to actually kill them. I guess he wastes me here, yeah. There's no reason not to. Feel like I'd probably attack with Mongoose too, but. Alright, well, that's a pretty bad draw. Sort of awkward at waste because I can, like, leave up Bolt to like trade Bloodbraid plus guy, Bob plus guy, I suppose. Or I can do something actually good, but I don't get to. It's one or the other kind of thing. Alright, well. I guess this way, if he attacks, I can like trade here and then block here and bolt. Might be able to hear my dog barking in the background. I have no idea what she's barking at. All right, she's mad at something. Okay. So this gives us some amount of outs to like Liliana and Abrupt Decay and such. I guess I have a chump blocker to like let me live one more turn after I like drop this library. Yeah, a Goyf's pretty good draw, so. I guess I kinda screwed up. I wish I had tutored for a green red land instead of a black red land. Didn't really think it would come up, but like, not like after getting that green source waste landed, you know, like I would like to be able to gain life this turn to get out of bolt range. Because if he finds a bolt here, I'm just dead. So that was probably a mistake. I don't know. You do, like, I did already have the Grove, and with Punishing Fire, you do kind of want a lot of red sources, and you need black sources more than anything in the deck in general. So you have multiple double black spells. I don't have any double green or double red, but hindsight being 20/20, it's pretty stupid. Oh, now I can't even gain life. Jeez. All right. So I guess we want Ponder. Take a Wasteland, make a green. Need to find, well, a land that would gain me life would be good. A way to kill his Goyf would be good. Alright. Could him. This card probably doesn't do a lot or he'd have cast it. So I think I'm better off just continuing to try and ping him here. Right, do we have another? Yeah, Ponder. Alright, well, that's not the worst draw. I guess now we can't die to Forked Bolt. That's really all that does for us. Nah, I don't really think I care to pay for this. Think I'd rather be using my Deathrite Shaman. Alright, so might have a stuffle. Doesn't really affect if I do this or not, but this gets through this kind of. Now, why wouldn't you just do that? Alright. Alright. Yeah, I guess he had it drawn it, so. But yeah, I'm dead to it. Yeah, whatever. Okay. Fetch or not, I'm dead. Like, if he does it before I fetch, I can't, like, respond. Alright, so we do want this and want Life from the Loam because we're trying to waste each other. We want Red Elemental Blast. We definitely do not want Thoughtseizes. We don't really want to pay life against this aggressive deck and don't really care that much about any other individual cards. Maelstrom Pulse is kind of a random catch-all. I don't think we need it against this deck, though it is a way to kill Goyf. But I don't think it's better than anything we have. Like, Hymn-to-Torak's only okay against them, but it is still a 2-for-1. I guess, maybe I'd rather have a pulse to affect the board. Alright. I actually just added pulse to the board. I'm not even sure it'll end up being in there, but.
Woo.